Welcome to Naples and to the Summer Universiade of 2019 and to race walking. This is the 20-kilometre race walk we're about to get underway in Mergellino. It's a flat course and the road surface is very good. So we're expecting a quick time in both races. Aneška Drahatova of the Czech Republic will be in bib 113. Katie Howard, Philippa Hughes and Jemima Montag there for Australia. So there's a team event embedded in this competition as well. And the best combined times for your team can place you in contention to win. Chinese athletes there, Yin Jiajing has a time of 120 plus, so he's a chance. Declan Tingay, the sole Australian in the field. And sprinklings of single athletes as well as teams in that Japan would look to have a lock on the team competition unless they incur the wrath of the judges. So the athletes being invited now up to the start. Here we go. Four athletes are away in the men's and women's 20K walk in Mergellina, Naples. And a good brisk start as they head off for the first lap of 1 kilometre. We'll be looking to see who wants to set the early pace when the moves are made and keeping an eye on the activity of the judges. The judges are watching contact with the ground, of course. There's got to be no visible loss of contact. That's sometimes the contentious point. It's what the eye can see. You might be able to slow-mo it down to see that occasionally both feet are off the ground, but you've got to be able to see it with the naked eye, and that's what the judges are required to do. And what makes race walking unique, I suppose, is that the advancing leg has got to be straightened, not bent at the knee, from the moment it touches the ground until it's vertical under the walker. And any of those contact infractions, sometimes called lifting. So they're starting off together, and so expect that the men will cover the distance more quickly than the women, so the men should separate themselves from the women's field. And that's happening now with Francesco Fortunato of Italy leading them out. He'll be a popular winner if he was able to do that. There's Chen Ru in one, but we'll be looking for the Japanese competitors who are 7, 8 and 9 by their bib numbers. And for the women, Drahotova is in 113 and Su Wenshu of China in 108, and Katie Howard of Australia, the other athlete who's done the 20Ks this season in under 90 minutes, she is in 101. 17 at the back of the field there, Kate Veal from Ireland, and 23 is Joana Pontes of Portugal. And Fortunato just putting on a little bit of a second effort. You can see Ikeda there in seven, just looking around, see how his teammates and rivals are traveling. The three Japanese, I think, are maintaining position in that pack. Katie Haywood, an insignificant lead of the group of four for the women. 24 there is Monika Hornikova of Slovakia. Race walking's got a very long history, and it can be traced back, competitive race walking, to 2,500 BC, when the Egyptian hieroglyphics record that there were walking competitions. So the Japanese trio have got Fortunato in their sights. And do they keep going? Is Ikeda happy to make a move here? Mm-hmm. Kader has got this this way about him. He's looking around, checking with his teammates. I don't know. I think he's the kind of guy who might actually enjoy the view. He's got a few quirks about his racing style. And, Kate Veal in 17 there, just being lapped now by the three leaders. And Wang, who was with these three, is now struggling as the athletes do take the opportunity for the refreshment. And you saw briefly there the gap back to Wang. So it looks like Hayward, Montag and Drahatova established a mini break over the Chinese athlete. The women's event quickly separated itself out with a smaller lead group. Fortunato, he and Sino Dunsu of Italy and Turkey respectively, they've got the same issue. They don't have any teammates around them. Jemima Montag in the women's event, she's a Commonwealth Games gold medalist. We'll come back to that when we see the women again. And Ikeda starting off to the right there. So Montag in three. She won the gold medal at the Commonwealth Games last year on the Gold Coast in Australia. She's 21 years of age now, out of Melbourne. Not tall, at 159 centimetres. And I was fortunate enough to be at the Commonwealth Games on the Gold Coast. It was a enjoyable occasion, and I think the athletes who made their way there also enjoyed the hospitality up in southeast Queensland. As the leading men's group, Fortunato still there, Ikeda the favourite, Kawano and Koga hoping to get Japan across in the team competition, but Chen and Yin and Zhang for China also strong contenders in that area. And then we also have the man from Turkey, Sahin Senodunsu. Eight in the lead pack, single file. So come through the start-finish area again. Fortunato just dropping to the back of that lead pack. And still this sort of busy manner about him, looking around, checking things out, the time, the opposition. Katie Hayward now moving up to lap Sarah Vitiello. So now we've got two clear leaders. Ikeda's put 8 seconds between himself and the next five. Fortunato's still in that group. And the two other Japanese competitors. But Ikeda is making it look a different sport. Ikeda just looks like he might be hurting a little. Sets back the other way. And that's, of course, on a loop like this that's just 1 kilometre long and a hairpin bend at either end, you can immediately see how far you are in front of the pursuers. Katie Hayward. To the left there, so Ikeda is gradually making his way past the leading women. He's already gone past Montag and now to the leading female athlete, Katie Hayward. So just for a moment, we catch the leaders of both events in the one shot. And Hayward, we go, oh, that guy's traveling. he's lifted the pace dramatically to establish his lead. Hasn't backed off much and moving there past Valentina Merunchuk of Ukraine. Mm-hmm. Nadia Gonzalez Manjares and Katarzyna Zadiblo of Mexico and Poland. Next to watch the disappearing figure of Koki Ikeda. Quite a few people out in the Friday morning sunshine to watch this great athlete. Kate Veal of Ireland, about to be passed. 19, there is Miroslav Juratnik of Slovakia. Oh, looks like she's struggling. That's Wang Na in 9. As Rajkina comes up beside her. Ikeda maybe just taking a moment to admire the water view. Certainly the water's got to look tantalizing at this point of a hot morning and a long race. 20 Ks they're doing, and Ikeda's not far from a finish now. He's on his last lap. Ikeda. Well, he came in as the favorite. He's one of the fast improving athletes in the sport. Plenty of attention on his performance today. He's got to keep them coming to make sure he's in this Japanese team for next year. As he continues to impress Japanese athletics, then I'm sure we're going to see him on our screens in 12 months' time. He just took his time. There was no panic when Francesco Fortunato of Italy made the early move. There was a big chasing pack, and Fortunato fell back to them. And then they raced as a group of, well, initially 11, and then down to 6, and then Ikeda made his move, and he's 27 seconds ahead of Kawano. So these are sort of semi-dangerous moments towards the end of the race, and fatigue really starting to kick in, that your technique doesn't break down. Yuta Koga racing there with Sonadunsu of Turkey. So the race for the minor medal is pretty interesting. So just about 500 meters to go now for Koki Ikeda. Pressure of expectation squarely on his shoulders coming into the race, and he's carried it around this beautiful circuit as though it's no load at all. Sonadunsu in third place now for Turkey, so he's broken up the stranglehold on the medals that Japan had. So Yuta Koga has drifted out of the top three. And even if there is a little bit of distress on the face of Koki Ikeda, he's holding it together. And he knows the finish line is almost in sight. So he can add it to his list of recent victories on the world stage. Ikeda. And then Kawano. So it might be Japan 1-2. It's 25 seconds to the good. Ikeda with the Japanese flags waving. 20 there. Sonadunsu trying to stay in the hunt for the medals. And Kawano in second place at the moment, behind his teammate. That'll be now. Koga has moved past Sonadunsu into third, so we're looking again at a 1-2-3-4 Japan. And Ikeda still with a good clip nearing the finish line. Coming up towards Philippa Hughes in two in the women's race. But Ikeda takes the hat off, takes the glasses off, takes on the field and beats them. It's Ikeda for Japan in the 20K walk for the men. He's impressive. He's world class. He's got himself tangled up in the finish tape. And quickly there to claim the Japanese flag, and I'm sure to acclaim his teammates in just a moment. Looking for a 1-2-3. Kawano is coming up next. He's also discarded the cap. And he's delighted to follow in his teammate. And then it will be Yuta Koga. He's managed to drop off Senadunsu and move into third position. So a dream result for Japan. 1-2-3. And still with some racing to do. It's Katie Hayward. Got to be a slightly sinking feeling while you're still racing and you're watching the men finish, but you wish your race was done as well. And Fortunato, a gutsy race from him. Australia and Italy with strong cultural and historical connections. A lot of Italians moved to Australia after the Second World War. So there is a big Italian community in Australia, particularly in Sydney and Melbourne. And it's always high on the list of Australian travellers to come to Italy. So hear so much about it and its beauty and history, and certainly learn about it in the education system. So feels like a natural thing to do, to come to Italy, but to compete in a race walk isn't on the agenda for many. Certainly is though for Katie Hayward, Jemima Montag and Philippa Hughes. So Drahatova, I wonder why there's been a little drop off in form for her, because she certainly comes in with European junior titles behind her. Hayward, not much of the race left for her as she comes up beside Maria Filiuk of Ukraine. Now I believe that bell would have been for Hayward, as the judge showed her one finger as in one lap. So coming up to 89 minutes of racing. And the gap between Montag and Hayward, almost half a minute. So there's not going to be a change between those two. Hayward. Well, there'll be fatigue, there'll be pain, but there's the prospect of crossing the line first, and that can really carry you across the closing few hundred metres. She knows she's well in front. Really an important time to concentrate on technique. Make sure the judges have got nothing to quibble with. And she's got half the final lap done, and she turns for home. And a minute 30 between Montag and Drahatova. Well, that really does settle the top two positions. Between Drahatova and her nearest pursuers, I'm not sure at this stage, but it'll be a disappointment, I think, for the Czech. But the current form really tells the tale. For Drahatova, there's 7 minutes between her season's best and her personal best. still trying to cool the body down. It's probably absolutely cooking inside. As we come up to 8:30 in the morning. Fairly warm conditions. We'd be in the mid-20s already. See if my phone will tell me. But the athletes have handled it pretty well. There hasn't been a lot of evidence of dropouts. Currently 25 degrees in Napoli, so we're heading for another 30 degree day, and an obvious and wise decision to hold the racing early as Hayward moves towards the finish and what will be a victory for Australia, and probably a 1-2 after a sweep of the medals in the men's for Japan. Hayward, not long to go, around one more bend along the seashore of Mergellina. They really have picked out a beautiful spot to conduct this race walk. Seconds back to Montag, so she made a move some time ago. They were racing as a team early, but then it's an individual contest ultimately, as well as a team. And around she comes. Not long to go now. Jemima Montag will finish second. And it's all about Katie Hayward at the moment as she nears the finish line. And the tape is there and the smile is there. And Katie Hayward wins the 20K walk. Don't think she wants to let go of it. Well, this is a big moment in her career. One of the most important victories she's had. She takes the Universiade 20K walk, and an Aussie supporter offers her the flag. Montag blows a kiss to some friends in the crowd and comes across in second place, a 1-2 for Australia.